We're going to certainly have to work off all of the fried food and the tortillas. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I was going
to
say, they're kind of healthy types here. Time right? for Workout Wednesday. Sometimes, you know, you want to work out, but your body just doesn't really want to participate. You feel kind of achy, creaky. And today we're talking about California Family Fitness's Ouida Selby, how you can still get out and do a workout. And Ouida, if you're recovering from surgery or just kind of life in general, sometimes you just don't feel like it.
That's right. And you do need to assess how your body is feeling, and you can go through your body and do a joint check, but you do want to keep moving. You want to start from the head and go down to the toes. Do some easy muscular movement.
All right, Candy's just doing some
shoulder shrugs. She loosened up her neck. She wants to check her knees and her ankles. And you want to do some deep breathing, too. Mm-hmm. And you want to get oxygen going to those muscles before you begin working.
Okay, and these are things, I mean, you can be doing this while you're watching our morning news. You're literally just kind of getting stuff moving just a little bit.
Yes.
So if you're somebody who has, you know, had some back pain from whatever, and you are feeling some pain even as you're doing these simple things, does that mean you should stop?
Oh, absolutely not. You do want to monitor the pain, but you want to do some movement as long as it doesn't cause a flare-up or something like that.
Okay.
And you want to, movement is the best medicine, but not working hard through the pain.
Mm-hmm.
And just learning that you might have some limitations for a while in your recovery process, and just to gradually work into doing more difficult movements.
Take this the right way, but it doesn't look like she's doing much, but she still is doing something.
She's still better. She is limbering up those joints. She's waking up those muscles. She's added resistance now, which is going to add strength to those muscles. If you are in that recovery mode, from injury, from surgery, or from whatever, or an issue that you've been having for a while, you really want to do safe movements. You can move, but you really want to try to avoid the bouncy movements, because then you're not taking care of your joints.
And these are just 2-pound weights.
Yes. Yes. You want to start out light, and then you can progress to the heavier weights.
Right. And I think some people might see it and go, well, gosh, it's just a 2-pound weight. Is it really that worth it? But what's interesting about this is even professional cyclists, you know, we've got Amgen coming up in just a week or so. This is how, when they have a bad crash and they're rehabbing, they start with something just as simple.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Because you don't want to continue to injure what has been injured. Mm-hmm. You know, exactly.
And doesn't it mentally just give you a boost that you know you're doing something?
Absolutely. When you work those muscles and you're taking in that oxygen, you're getting those happy chemicals going on into your brain called those endorphins.
And we like the happy chemicals.
The happy chemicals. And when we're not feeling well or we had an injury, we can get depressed, and this will help us get rid of some of that depression.
Good. It's a good start. So how long for this little starter workout are you going to do?
She can warm up for 3 to 5 minutes and then begin to progress and add more intense movements onto it.
All right. Ouida and Candy, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Feeling worked out?
Yes.
You're doing all
okay.
right. Okay. We'll be back with more right after this.